now, America's number one show on pop culture and politics. This is the Michael Medved Show.
And another great day in this greatest nation on God's green earth.
The approach of putting a huge emphasis on race and racial identity. And that appears to be almost an obsession with the left. And it's been reflected in a particularly sick way regarding a case in the L.A. area. And it's a case in Santa Clarita Valley involving a apparently beautiful little girl. They're very sensitive about not showing her face, who is about to be taken away from her family, the only family she's ever known. Why? Because she is 1.5%, 1/64th Native American. This is an amazing story, as reported on by KBC TV. Listen.
They are the picture of a happy family. But Rusty and Summer Page say tomorrow could be the worst day of their lives and the life of their six-year-old foster daughter, Lexi.
She's a very happy girl, and she's a part of our family, and we love her dearly.
Lexi spent time in two other foster homes before the Pages took her in 4 years ago to live with them and their three young children. They want to adopt her.
The reality of it is when she was two and came here, that she knew us as mom and dad, and she really doesn't know anyone else as mom and dad.
Okay, and so what's the problem exactly? The problem is an idiotic piece of legislation that was passed back in 1970. It is called the Indian Child Welfare Act. It's a federal law. And because of that federal law, there could be some extremely unpleasant real-world consequences.
Tomorrow, the L.A. County Department of Child and Family Services plans to come to the Page family's home, take Lexi away, and send her to live with a family in Utah. The decision was made because of her heritage. Lexi is 1.5% Choctaw, and her case fell under the Indian Child Welfare Law, a federal law passed in the 1970s aiming to protect the best interests of Native American children and promote stability of tribal families.
It's 1/64th of her heritage, and because of that, she's been funneled in to this Native system through DCFS.
Okay, this is obviously completely outrageous, don't you think? I mean, the idea that this little girl who has lived with his family for 4 years is about to be ripped out by government officials because the family that has taken her in and raised her as a foster child, they want to adopt her, that family is white and she is 1/64th Choctaw. She therefore has to go to a much more distant, to a distant family that she doesn't really know in Utah because she's 1/64th Choctaw. I mean, would it even matter, frankly, if she were half Choctaw or all Choctaw? What is it about judging people by race, by skin shade, by ancestry that would undermine one of the most beautiful things you can do, which is to adopt a child, to give a child a loving home? Now, if they were saying that they wanted to take her out of the home because this family was abusive or it was racist or it was somehow discriminatory or the girl was unhappy somehow, then okay. But according to every report, and I've read several of them, in this particular family, they seem to be exemplary. And she loves her home that has been the only home she can remember that she's lived in for 4 years. This is outrageous. And one thing I want to say about the adoptive parents, Summer and Rusty Page, they're also extremely reasonable about trying to accommodate the folks who wanted Lexi to go back to Utah, apparently, or to go to Utah and to be part of the Choctaw Nation. Listen.
The Pages say they supported an earlier plan that would have returned Lexi to her birth father. But according to court documents, in 2012, he distanced himself from his daughter. They began a legal battle to keep her after learning she would be sent to live with extended relatives in Utah. They lost their most recent court appeal yesterday.
And it just tore us apart, because to think that our child could leave for such a stupid thing.
In a statement, a court-appointed attorney for Lexi says, her family in Utah have been waiting to receive her for over 3 years. During that time, they have traveled to California monthly, and she has visited their home as well. The injustice here is not that she is leaving California, but rather that her foster parents pursued litigation, which prevented her from joining her family sooner.
I'm going to tell her that I'm her mommy, and that I love her, and that she's very special, and that she deserves to be in a home with us that she wants to be in.
Okay, that she wants to be in. That I believe is the mother who is trying to take this child out of the home in which she lives. Now, there have been other cases like this, and I will tell you that my approach to any of these cases is if a child is adopted by loving parents. And then if some birth father turns up, you may remember that baby Richard case years and years ago. I think it was about 25 years ago, where they also took a child. And he was not even as old as this girl is. This girl is 6 years old. She has grown accustomed to this family. And you can look at some of the family photos. If you look at the imagery, and we'll post some of it up at our website at michaelmedved.com, it's very, very obvious that this little girl fits in with the family with which she has been living. And the notion that because of some very partial racial background, for goodness sake, this little girl is about as much Native American as Elizabeth Warren is, which is not which is not deeply, deeply Native American. At least that's her tribal identity, her Choctaw tribal identity. Now, look, I understand the Choctaw tribe and the way that they want to say that this is part of their values, that their values have to do with pride and with heritage and with keeping families stable and et cetera, et cetera. But how does this help keeping families stable? It's extraordinary, frankly, and it's terribly, terribly sad. And it seems to me that this is exactly the kind of approach that is very, very typical of the left, which believes that the way that you help people get out of poverty or you help people get ahead or you help address economic equality is more attention on race. Can we understand that paying great attention to race, putting race ahead of anything else, or putting race ahead of anything, is a way to keep people in poverty and to perpetuate injustice, not to end it? That seems to me obvious.